Let us read projection of planes problem once again and start to solve it in advanced mode. Circular plane having radius 30 mm is resting on point of its circumference in such a way that topmost point on this plane is at 30 mm from HP. So idea is that base point is given. We will assume that this base point is 0 mm above HP and that is A. And other point is given, that is point B is 30 mm above HP. Obviously, highest point will be point on diameter. One point will be in base, other point will be in top. So this is basically describing two ends of the diameter of this circle. Then draw the projections of plane if, here it's not if, like it's not is, but if top view of diameter passing through the point on HP makes an angle of 60 degrees with XY line. So top view of diameter passing through point HP means beta angle is given for this diameter. So we do not need to calculate beta, but directly beta is given. So if somebody is once again trying to calculate beta for this problem, then there will be error in this problem because you may end up calculating super beta. So idea is that beta is already given, so there is no need to calculate beta. And we have to find out angle made by the plane with respect to HP. So 30 mm radius means 60 mm diameter multiplied by 3, 180 plus 20 gap, so 220 plus on both sides 10 mm. So 240 mm is the maximum length within which one should be able to complete this problem. So that's the maximum dimension which is required. You don't need more than this dimension. Always it's better to estimate how much size of the page you want to solve this problem. Now let us directly draw the circle. Radius is 30 mm. So slightly take it down. Okay. Then draw horizontal line. And then divide this circle using polar array command in 12 parts. Select the object, enter, select the center and change number of atoms to 12. So you have divided this circle into 12 equal parts. Now you have to annotate it. My general choice is annotation should be A and B for one of the diameters for circle, and others I generally like to label it using numericals, like numeric labels. This helps in identifying points very quickly. If we are not labeling it, like if all are numerical, then sometimes it may create some confusions. And if all are letters, then also sometimes it confuses. So let's have two letters and 10 numerical labels. This will be really nice. Now let us start to draw the projectors. Not a difficult task to draw it, but make sure that all projectors for, let's say, 1 and 10, 2 and 9, such projectors should lie on, such point should have a single projector because of the geometry in question. Now I have completed my stage number 1. So let's say this is A dash, this is 1 dash and 10 dash. This point is 2 dash comma 9 dash. This point is 3 dash comma 8 dash. Then next point is 4 dash comma 7 dash. And next point is 5 dash comma 6 dash. And then B. It's better if you keep all the points in, it looks nice if you are having all the points in one height, so just take care that all points are having same height. So it looks presentable. Even if your heights of the point, like labels are not correct, like not same, doesn't matter, it's not wrong, but it will give you more confusion in the person's mind who is reading your problem, okay, or who is checking your problem. It may create confusion in his mind. Now whatever is final projector, whatever is final projections, make it bold. Whenever object is completed, my suggestion to you is that you should always show the dimension of that immediately. And here radius is given, so you should show radius. Otherwise, sometimes what happens, radius is given and you draw diameter, or diameter is given, you draw radius. These problems will not arise. And even if they are there, you may be able to rectify them if you are giving correct dimensions. Okay, if radius is given, you should show radius. You may consider that once stage 1 is complete, but it's not complete because we have not located point A1-10-2-9-. We don't have locations of these points. So using multiple point command, you may locate these points. Just for sake of identification, these point, like I have changed their point types to cross. You may use any type which you want, or you may just say I don't want to have any point type to point. So our first stage is done. Now let us go to next step. In next step, we have to copy this. See, while going from stage 1 to stage 2, there is no change in front view shape, but there is change in orientation of front view. Also, between stage 1 and stage 2, it's always better to keep 20 mm distance. So here diameter is 60, so 60 plus 20, 80 mm is distance with which I should move this point. Sorry. So once again, let me select this point, say copy, enter. I will select the center and then I will move it by 80 mm. So it will be appropriate. Then I will use offset command, because in problem statement it is said that topmost point of plane is 30 mm from HP. So point B dash is 30 mm above HP. So I will use offset of 30 mm and I will move this by 30 mm and then I will change its type to normal line, and then I have to rotate this. So I will use R command, center start end, click on this and I will disable, I will disable ortho mode for some time. Just a minute, let me disable ortho mode and then let me use center start end. Okay, I have done that. So point B should go at this intersection and all other points should also rotate, because I am going to rotate my front view. So there is command rotate, and I will click on point with which I am going to rotate, A point, then I am going to rotate it with reference. Okay, but I don't know what is the angle, so I will say click on this, and click on this, I am going to rotate AB line. Once again, I don't know what is the angle, but I know points. So my points are, A is this point and B is intersection point. So I have rotated this complete object, and now I am going to rotate its labels also. Okay, so this way I have completed my step 2. Now in question it is also asked, what is the angle made by plane with respect to HP. So if you directly tell it, it's 30 degree. Obviously height of this point is 30 mm. Okay, and diameter is 60 mm. So sine theta half theta inverse is 30. So that's what is expected. And now generally I always like to draw horizontal projectors first, as I already discussed, because distance of these points do not change from VP. So these are kind of more fixed projectors compared to vertical projectors, and it's always better from easiness in drawing to draw horizontal projectors first. So I will draw A, I will draw point B, then like here. Idea is that node we have to select. Okay, I have noted 10 point, I have noted 1 point, then using node 0.9, and then I have located 0.2. then using selections of center, 8 and 3 are located. Now using 4 and 7, once again 7 and 4 are shown, and then finally 0.6 and 0.5 are, sorry, 0.6 and 0.5 are denoted. Now TR, double enter. Whatever is additional part, you should delete it. So it will reduce complexity in your drawing. And using multiple points, join the points which you want to, like around which you have to draw the smooth curve for second stage. Okay. See, these nodes or these points, you may not show it. You can directly draw the curve. But as a, precaution, I don't like it to draw it directly. But I always like to draw, like my suggestion to you is always you should show the point first and then you should connect it. So this way, like, probability of making error is reduced, and ultimately it's not about whether you are able to draw it or not. It's about how can you make less and less mistakes. If you make less mistakes and if you follow procedure properly, probability is that your solution will be correct, because not much complication is there in terms of concept of this. So now using spline command, spline, one should connect this these points. So whatever you do using French curve, or let's say freehand curve in on pen and drawing paper, same thing you are going to do it using spline command in AutoCAD. So we have completed our second stage, and final stage is asking draw the projections of plane if top view of diameter passing through point on HP. So top view of diameter passing through point HP is AB. So let me make it bold. Actually, this whatever bold I have made, just for sake of understanding, nothing else. Okay, it's making an angle of 60 degree. So this is very simple problem. Let's copy this. Click on starting point and then click it here. So I have completely copied this problem. Whatever inside projectors which are there, you delete these projectors, and now I have to rotate it at 60 degree. Original angle is 0, so I can directly show this angle 60 degree. Okay, angle is anti-clockwise, so problem solution has gone above. So what I will do, I will just move it at the bottom first and then I will rotate it. It will be much easier. You know, like instead of showing the angle and then rotating it. Okay, then I will select all and I will move it to the right. Okay, so there is like wrong label I have moved, doesn't matter. See, this facility is available in AutoCAD, copy paste. This is very useful facility. That's why you don't need, because of this facility, you actually don't need auxiliary method, except for cases in which you have to find out angle made by the plane or true shape of plane. Except for such cases, you don't need auxiliary method in AutoCAD. So what I will do, I will delete this and I will draw these horizontal projectors first, as I already have suggested. Horizontal projectors will reduce my efforts, okay, because they are quite straightforward projectors. And then every point I will locate A, then one is slightly above, two is above, three, four, five, there is a mistake. 5 and 6 projectors have not been drawn correctly. So TR, double enter, just delete this. By symmetry, you understand. See, whenever you are drawing problem systematically, whatever errors you are going to make, you can rectify it while drawing. But if you are not doing problem systematically, there is higher risk of making mistakes, and that risk of taking care of those mistakes is also very less. So let's say this is point A dash, let me move it to the bottom, then this is point B. Okay, I may not denote other points if I want, but I will denote it for sake of completion. In circle problem, let me tell you, maximum efforts are there to draw the labels. Otherwise, circle problem is very, all the circle problems are very straightforward problems. Only efforts one requires is in labeling it. And it's very cumbersome, because at least 12 points, if you divide circle in 12 points, then only your smooth curve is there, you are able to draw a very good smooth curve. That's why 12 points per shape means total 6 shapes we are, or 6 views we are drawing. So 72 labels you have to draw. So it's quite cumbersome if you are having circle problem to solve, but it's not that difficult. So there is give and take, you don't have very much critical problem, but you have time consuming problem. So if you are not able to solve other problem, generally I will say that circle problem, if it's there in examination, you just keep it as a second choice. Okay, then TR, double enter, whatever is additional part, you just truncate these parts. Okay, and now join it using spline. A-line-E, A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, B, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, once again 1, okay, and then select TR, enter, select this, enter, and then you select additional small portions which are coming in front. These are the actual projectors, okay, and probably you have completed this solution. Only issue is, you have not shown what is the angle made by the plane with respect to PP or XY line. That you have to show here. So you have completed the solution. Okay, and as you have done calculation in first part, it is able to accommodate this problem in given, 240 was the estimate which we had done, and it's able to accommodate that problem in 240 mm, if you have seen. So that is why estimation of how much space is required is very important. Now once again revise the problem. stage first, true shape, front view line. Stage 2, rotate the front view at an angle based on the condition. No change in shape of front view, but change in orientation of front view. Then based on it, draw view number 4, top view in second stage. Then top view, beta is not required, so directly rotate the top view and you will get shape number 5. And accordingly, shape number 6 or view number 6, you can join. Now you may ask one more question. Sir, why you have drawn this line AB like this, okay, or diameter like this? Answer is, there are 4 solutions possible. I will show you all 4 solutions. For example, I may choose this AB, like, instead of this, I may choose it like this. So this is another correct solution. I may change it like this, mirror. Okay, so there are 4 types of solutions. 1, 2, 3, 4 types of solutions which are possible for given problem. Right now I have selected only this solution. I will show it in like blue color. So whatever solution I have shown is, or let me change it, the color, it's not looking, let me make it orange. So whatever orange color I have shown, that's the one solution out of 4 possible solutions I have selected. So all 4 solutions are correct. Only case in which I may say that point A is nearer to observer compared to point B, or let's say point B is nearer to observer compared to point A, such conditions will eliminate 2 more solutions. That's the additional condition if ever it is asked in problem. Otherwise all 4 solutions are theoretically correct and should be given due credit. So we have solved this problem. Thank you.